So, guess what, dumbass? Went out to film a vlog and got 13 minutes of audio on a nice EMS Chronicles vlog and ended up with nothing because he didn't turn the camera on. That would be this dumbass right here. So, I'm gonna try again. While I ride around feeling like a rebel with my highly illegal exhaust. So, here we go. What is up, everybody? This is Skunk72 coming at you from the once again warm Southern California. Believe it or not, over the past month or so, we have actually had a winter. We've had snow, we've had lots of rain. So I'm just now getting around to the second episode of what, with a little help of Viper 6 and Autotech HCL, I've decided to call Skunk's EMS Chronicles. So welcome to episode 2 of Skunk's EMS Chronicles. So before I get into the story, which is going to be a quick funny one, and it's actually hot off the presses, just happened yesterday while I was at work. I want to give a quick rest in peace to a couple of heroes. Their first one is going to be Captain Mike Shepard, which I knew personally. I ran a lot of calls with him back when he was a firefighter paramedic, and then he promoted to engineer. Then when he promoted to captain, he ended up coming back and working in the area with me. Mike, he was killed in a car accident about a month ago now. It's been that long since I rode, I haven't been able to talk about it. So, we don't know exactly what happened. He reared off the road and rear-ended a dump truck, and don't know if he had a medical emergency while he was driving and or what. We have no idea. But anyway, he was killed in the accident. He was off duty at the time. I'm gonna throw a picture of him up here real quick. Rest in peace, Mike. Love your brother. You'll never be forgotten. Then there's also another one. I can't remember his name, but I'm gonna look it up and I'll put it up here in a graphic. From the Ventura County Search and Rescue Sheriff's Department team. This gentleman was actually killed when his crew was on the way to a training exercise. They saw an accident happen on the freeway. It's what we in California call the grapevine. It's Interstate 5, and it's really high elevation, so there's a lot of stuff that goes on up there. There's a lot of snow. It's constantly getting closed for snow. But this team, believe it or not, this is what police officers do. They saw somebody in need of help and stopped the help, even though it was not their area to be doing it. While working this accident in the bad weather, another car lost control and actually went through the accident scene. And from what I know, actually hit about 10 people going through, unfortunately killing this gentleman from search and rescue. So I'm gonna throw a picture of him, and again, rest in peace, sir, you're one of my heroes. This particular accident I was actually responding to, and if we would have been closer, may have been up there when the accident happened. I did have friends up there. But anyway, on to my story. Again, this just happened yesterday. So when we get dispatched to things, our dispatch system is kind of old and outdated, and you can only get dispatched to a small number of things that comes up as the nature of the call. So we get dispatched on a call, and it comes in as animal bite. As we're on the way out, our dispatcher lets us know over the radio that it's multiple bee stings. So my thought is, okay, you know, somebody that's allergic to bees got stung a couple times, no big deal, let's go get them taken care of. So we take off and get on scene. Right as we're rolling up on scene, a lady comes running across the street and she's flailing her arms and running in circles, and didn't notice till we got a little closer, there was a swarm of bees just buzzing around in a circle over her head, and they were attacking her. I was shocked. So we roll up there to find out that she's not even the person that we were there for. The person that we were there for is inside the house, allergic to bees, and we have to go through this bee storm to get in there to get her. So me, I'm allergic to bees myself, so I was scared to death. So my partner, knowing that I'm allergic to bees, tells me, okay, here's what we're going to do. You just jump out, go to the side door, jump it back, and get our gurney set up and ready so we can go get the patient. We're just going to throw her in and we're going to get the hell out of here. Soon as we open the door, all kinds of bees come into our ambulance. I run over the back, open the back door, jump it there real quick, a bunch get in the back with me. So I'm trying to zip up my safety jacket, which has a really cheap plastic zipper on it, and somehow I didn't zip it right. So when I zipped it up, it's got a collar that goes all the way up around my neck. I zipped it up all the way because I wanted to keep the bees off my neck. Well, somehow I screwed up the zipper, so I get it zipped up to my neck and the bottom opened up. Well, my partner opens up the back door real quick, and I hear him say, "Ow! Oh, I got stung." So he says, "Screw this." He runs and jumps in the cab. Well, I'm in back with a packaged emergency blanket, and I really wish my partner would have filmed it, because he said it was hilarious watching me jumping around the back of the ambulance trying to kill all these bees with a blanket. So we end up going to get this lady. The fire paramedics, they went and got her. Everybody got stung on scene of this. Everyone, except for me. Somehow I managed to not get stung. So they go get her. We load her up, and again, a bunch more bees come in, and we load her up. And she was allergic, doing actually pretty good, though, because she had an EpiPen on her. She shot herself up with the EpiPen, and that took care of the breathing problems. Checking her out, I still saw that she had a bunch of hives. So we take care of her. We get her off to the hospital, and another ambulance had gone to pick up the other lady that we originally saw. Turns out that lady, she got stung in the face 30 times. And I was thinking, my God, if I would have gotten stung in the face 30 times, I'd be dead. I'd be done. Over with. I can take one and it will make me throw up and be sick. I don't even want to know what would happen if I get a second one all at the same time. Two doses of the bee venom. I'm assuming that if I would have gotten hit twice, I would have been a patient too. And it would have been the end of my day. And to top it off, I actually felt bad for being the only one there that didn't get stung. From what our patient told us is the bees have lived on that property. They live in a tree, and they've never been aggressive, ever. And all of a sudden yesterday was the first time that they'd ever done that, and they went crazy and attacked people. The only explanation I could come up with was it's been unusually cold here. That yesterday was finally a warm day. I was wondering if the bees just, woke up because it was warm and decided to have a little party. That will be the end of Skunk's EMS Chronicles Episode 2. Thank you very much, Viper 6 and Autotech HTL, for helping me come up with a cool title for it. I appreciate you guys. And until Episode 3, Riverside Down, Shineside Up, and I'll see you guys next episode. Talk to y'all later. Bye-bye.